Kyle, we already said hi, and I just wanted to, I'm happy you joined us as well, and I just wanted to ask you first really easy question. How many years are you already going to Zwolle?
Oh, do you know, I've lost count. Yeah. I think one, maybe I was fatter, maybe I was slimmer, I can't remember, but I was a lot younger, that's for sure. Few years, the best show in the world, I think, for carp fishing. Best pilgrimage for anglers. Yeah, I really like coming here.
Danny said it's in 25, some of the old years. It seems it's like 25 years ago.
Dan's coming. For me, it's like 10 years maybe. Ten years probably. Yeah, 10, 11 years.
But you know, whether it's Zwolle or not, you know, you're known that you're so long in this, living this passion.
Yeah.
And you still, you know, exhale this joy.
Yeah.
And, about fishing. What is actually the very essence of your fishing that drives you over again to the waterside? What is the thing that you're searching for when you go fishing?
I don't think anyone ever really knows the answer. There's so many different elements to the chemistry, you know, that changes as you get older. You start to think about mental health and get escaping commercialism and the outside, and then because it's mixed with my life, with my work, it's very hard to get the separation. So for me, I have to do different types of fishing. So I go sea fishing, but then when I do something different, it reminds me of when I was a kid fishing for the first time. So you realize it's so inside you, you can't. And now for me, I just want to share that with so many people that have never fished before. I want to take people that have never fished to see if they have the light inside, which I think many people have. They just never taste it.
It keeps you young fishing.
I think it makes you old in the head and young in the heart. Yeah, it's magical, you know. It's like, it's great. And not enough people, because of how the world is changing with technology and cameras and phones and computer games, not enough people are getting to experience that purity, you know, of being outside. Of course, everyone's got to earn money and live, but what a great pastime.
This is exactly the question I wanted to ask you afterwards, where I wanted to ask you about the dangers, you know, how can you lose the passion for fishing? What are the faults? But on the other hand, I could also ask is, how can you preserve the love and the passion for sports? How do you approach this? How would you say to the kids, you know, do like this and you will always stay a happy angler?
Yeah, I think we're doing a lot of work behind the scenes at the moment, planning some really big projects, and the focus is to get people that are very big names outside of fishing, that do a bit of fishing, to then endorse the sport, to go out and fish and to encourage kids to move, because I don't think the fishing industry on its own can achieve that. It needs a bigger industry to help drive kids, and it's got to be looking at angles like families being together and just being outside, nature, wildlife, family togetherness, mental health, PTSD, all of these things that it can help remedy, and the joys people can have, because I think we're just moving more and more away from just enjoying the basic things in life. And you then, when you do it, you remind yourself, wow, I didn't need to do this or spend this. Just being outdoors was enough to give me the best I felt in ages, you know? Yeah, that's what I love about it. And I've got a feeling inside that bit by bit, it will come back a little bit, you know? Kids will start to search for stuff and realize you can't find happiness sat in your bedroom constantly, you know?
Nice, man.
Yeah.
Nice words.
All right.
Thanks a lot. Cheers, man.